Hello dear students, welcome back to my channel The Learner's Digest. My name is Divya Khadi and today I'm here with part 2 of the chapter The Marathon of Hope that we've been doing in the last class. So let me give you all a quick recap of what happened in the life of Mr. Terry Fox. So we just realized that Terry had got cancer in his right leg, you know. So Terry was someone who loved challenges and he used to play basketball in his school as well as in his college. And when his career was really thriving, he suddenly got to know that he had cancer. Okay, so let's proceed from there. So I'm sure every one of you all must be understanding what I'm teaching you. I'm teaching it in a very simple way. So let's get back to page number 111 of your English books. Please follow the book with me. I'll read it first. Okay, so we were in paragraph number 16. Okay, but I can't lose my leg, he protested. I'm an athlete. Okay, so because the doctor told Terry Fox when they realized that he had cancer, Terry like cancer bhako thiyo usko right knee ma, usko ghoda ma, aina doctor told him that he had to lose his leg. Because the cancer cells will spread throughout the leg doctor. And just imagine the plight of Terry Fox. He is someone who plays basketball, and for a basketball player, his legs are so important. Basketball game. Okay. So he was like, I can't lose my leg. My legs are very important for me. I'm an athlete. I understand how you feel, replied the doctor. Nobody can understand how I feel, Terry said quietly. This was surely the greatest challenge Terry had ever faced in his life. This was surely the greatest. Okay, and Terry did face the challenge with spirit and determination as always. Barely 6 weeks later, Terry was walking around with an artificial leg and a cane in his hand. In the days that followed, Terry realized that he wasn't feeling too bad, but others were. Instead of cheering, he found that he had to cheer up people. Even his coach, who came to see him, seemed to feel bad. His coach had brought for him a magazine article. It was about Dick Trom, who also had an artificial leg and ran in the New York Marathon. Okay. So, what happened? Ultimately, Terry ko khutta katnai paryo kinabhane ulai cancer bhako thiyo. But then, after few months, he started walking with an artificial leg. And I'm sure all of you must be familiar with what is an artificial leg. Yani ra book ma pani, you all can see Terry Fox in page number 112 yahan nira yahan book ma pani di raheko cha. This is Terry Fox and here you can see this is his normal leg and one side ma chha ule artificial leg lagara ule hindaicha haina. So he loved challenges, so this was the greatest challenge that Terry had to face. Artificial leg lagara hindu sajilo chaina ni haina. So he started walking and then suddenly he was full of spirit and determination. Okay, he was not someone who would give up easily, haina tyo ta hamile yaadai thyo. Anta euta artificial khutta ra cane bhaneko euta stick huncha ni haina tyo longari hinneherle chai use garcha cane. So testo le chai o feri hinnu thalecha re. Then he started cheering up. Okay, ulai tyati saro naramro pani afno condition ma feel bhayena re. But his friends and family, everyone around him seemed to be so sad looking at him. There was a time when he had to cheer up people. Ule po manche la fokai raheko huncha ni ki it's okay, I'm good, I'm fine bhanera. Ule, the people were feeling more bad, but then Terry Fox was determined. He was back to normal again. Okay, and then his coach once ule jab usko coach le ula bhetnu aayo teti bela he got one book for him. It was about Dick Trom. Okay, it was a person, the book was about a person named Dick Trom who also had an artificial leg. Tara he had run for a marathon in New York. Okay, his I have a dream, a challenge for myself. I am going to run across the whole of Canada from sea to sea. It will be my marathon of hope. And all the money I will raise will go for cancer research. Okay, so what did Terry say? I also have a dream of challenging myself. I want to run for a marathon. So I guess every one of us are familiar with the term marathon. You know, people walk for long distances. It's not for bistari they run, okay, for marathon. And the marathons are taken up for a long distance. The 100 meter, 200 meter, ko the races, school sports event. But a marathon is a really prolonged run. Okay, this much a manche ru niki lamo kucha. So he Terry also wanted to run in the whole of Canada. Canada bhari chahi, he wanted to run and raise money. The marathon kuda firi chahi paisa haru pani uchcha ni haina. So jun chahi paisa ucheko huncha, the money which was raised, he wanted it to donate it for cancer research. Okay, so he wanted to do something for cancer research because he himself was suffering from cancer and he knows that how he feels. Okay, so it will be my marathon of hope, Banera Banisa. Terry began to prepare for his marathon. He started by running short distances, but within a month he was able to run a mile. Okay, so as we all know, Terry loved challenges, so he challenged himself into running a marathon. Bistari bistari ule practice pani garnu thalecha re, na? So page number 112, paragraph number 25. To test himself, Terry entered the Prince George Marathon. He intended to run only half the distance, but his friend Doug kept on saying, "Come on, Terry, you can finish." Terry did reach the finish line. After running 3,000 miles in training, Terry boarded a plane for Newfoundland on Canada's east coast. He was ready to take the challenge of a 5,300-mile run across Canada. On April 12, 1980, the day Terry started the run, his family and many others watched him on television in the morning news. He hoped to run 30 to 40 miles a day and be home at Port Coquitlam in 6 months' time. Okay, so to test himself whether he could run or not, Terry even participated in Prince George Marathon and he finished it. Okay, and now he felt himself that I'm ready to run my marathon of hope, Manera. He boarded a train for Newfoundland. That is the place where he started his marathon, on Newfoundland, which is in Canada's east coast. Okay, so he had challenged himself to run for 5,300 miles across the Canada, and his marathon started on April 12th 1980. That day everyone, his friends, family, all the public were watching the news on television on the day of his start of marathon. It's not every day that someone with an artificial leg walks a marathon. That also for a good cause, haina kina bhane chai ule chai manche haruko ramro ko lagi jun chai paisa thyo raise huna ateko thyo cancer ko research ma ule thyo paisa lagauna ateko thyo, haina. So everyone was very proud of whatever he was doing. So unharle chai Terry ko news TV ma here here he wanted to walk for 30 to 40 miles ek din ma chai hinera chai wherever he could take rest, he would rest, and then after 6 months of running, he would go back to his home, which is in Port Coquitlam. Okay, in St. John's, Newfoundland, Doug was there with Terry. Doug was driving a van donated by Ford Motor Company. They used petrol donated by Imperial Oil. Many other big companies also helped in many ways. As he ran across town, people cheered him. They even invited him for meals. In the first town he ran through, donations poured in, but it wasn't roses all the way. In some towns, there would be no one waiting, and that meant no money for cancer research. Sometimes he felt dizzy, but he would rest for a while, do 15 push-ups, and start running again. So look at the determination of Terry, you know. Then they can jab Newfoundland ma ule start garyo, his friend, we all know his name was Doug, usko sathi thyo Doug bhane, he was also there with Terry. Kin side by side jo pani marathon kucha unharko side by side vans haru gari haru hinai raheko huncha, because in between he might need water or he might feel sick, you know. So there are always people walking beside him, whoever can. accompany him just to give him a helping hand ke bhai hale bane for emergency reasons. Okay, so Doug was there and they were given a van by Ford Motor Company, and different companies also come forward to help for the good cause. Haina unale sponsor garcha ni haina, and the oil unale, they were using petrol which was sponsored by Imperial Oil, haina tyadekhi chai. As he walked different towns ma u jab kudde gayo run garde gayo teti bela chai different people came forward, some gave him food haina water haru dinde gayo tyadekhi chai kati eura bela ma chai he used to feel very dizzy haina unai ringata lagisayeko hunthyo kudera tara bha pani he used to rest for some time and then he used to again start रनिङ ओके एन्ड को टाउनमा त मान्छेहरूले आएर उसलाई हेल्प गर्थ्यो, डोनेसन्सहरू दिन्थ्यो, तर कतिवटा टाउनमा चाहिँ आएर मान्छेहरूले फेरि डोनेसन्स दिन्थेन, विच मिन्स नो मनी फर क्यान्सर. ओके, सो हि वाज कलेक्टिङ मनी अल्सो एन्ड इन सम टाउन्स पिपल वर नट गिभिङ मनी अल्सो. ओके, सो बोथ वेज. एन्ड देन टेरी मेड स्टेडी प्रोग्रेस running on Prince Edward Island and then across New Brunswick. The donations kept coming and Terry pounded out the miles no matter how tired he got. In Montreal, four wheelchair athletes and a football star, Don Sweet, accompanied Terry through the streets to a reception at the City Hall. Okay, so Terry was progressing through different towns. Okay, so he was in Prince Edward Island, then he crossed New Brunswick, and the donations also kept on coming because Terry was so determined. म चाहिँ कुच्चै कुच्छु, म चाहिँ यो गुड कजको लागि यो म्याराथन कम्प्लिट गर्छै गर्छु. टेरीको डिटर्मिनेसन देखेर चाहिँ मान्छेहरूले पुरा डोनेसन्सहरू पनि दियो, उसलाई पुरा हेल्प पनि गर्यो, कतिजनाले उसलाई रिसेप्सन पनि दियो. वेन हि युज रिच इन सम स्ट्रिट्स, पिपल वर देयर टु रिसिभ हिम. ओके, सो दिस इज द जर्नी अफ टेरी फक्स सो फार फर हिज म्याराथन अफ होप. सो विल डु टिल हियर एन्ड देन आई विल अल्सो make part 3 of the chapter, and there we'll complete the chapter. And as the drill goes, do like, share and subscribe to my channel, dear students, and please leave your valuable feedback in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to reply to your messages, and your comments and your likes motivates me to make good videos for all of you. So stay tuned for more videos. I'll not only be making videos for class 6 but also for class 9 science videos are also coming up. So please stay tuned, and goodbye and take care and stay safe.